How's it going? I'm Ina Golden and welcome to my book. So, today we are continuing this little mini-series of important characters in the multiverse and we are focusing on Jay. Now finally I get to talk about a character who isn't just part of the Circle of Six or just a very limited number or versions of. This is a character that appears a lot and has various different either complete name changes or partial name changes depending on where in the multiverse that you are. I haven't focused on too many variations of him yet. In terms of what I've written, in terms of stories that he, as a character, has appeared, there are four primary versions that have sort of appeared. Three are, yes, in the Circle of Six, unfortunately. and the fourth is actually in the relative future reality. And is the only one that doesn't have the same or very similar backstory to the rest of them. So I don't know if you consider that exciting or not, but yeah, so I will sort of divide this into two parts, this video, I mean, into two parts, and talk about the Circle of Six variants and then the future reality variant. Just because there is a departure, obviously, once you get outside of the Circle of Six as to how he sort of appears. So yeah, let's, without further ado, sort of get into this one and begin at the beginning with the Circle of Six. So within the story set within the Circle of Six, as I mentioned before, there are three versions there. Two of those versions you sort of meet post-death. I don't know if that's spoilerish or not, so I'm not gonna go and delve too far into that. And the other one is the version in Hyena Boy, where it's essentially the sort of one version of the backstories to all of the variants that you get in the Circle of Six, and I'm pretty sure that Jay is not the same Jay that you get in the other stories that are focused on him, even though they've all had very similar histories and very similar backstories being within the Circle of Six and having that sort of connection there. So they definitely, you know, their version of events isn't that far removed, but the reason I think he is a different one is I'd like him to be a different one to the other two. I know he's definitely a different one to the one that appears in Tales, because the Tales saga somehow, this is weird to explain, the Circle of Six, although still very similar in terms of events and stuff and relative people that sort of appear in them, three of the realities, and it's 1, 2, and 6, are set on a slightly different time path. At some point during the sort of history, some event has happened or some event has not happened, which has altered where in history certain events start to occur. And 6 is ahead of everything else by a few years. Because something either did or didn't happen, which has sort of set everything sort of slightly ahead. And that they're the sort of the earliest in time. 1 and 2 are sort of within a few years of each other. They're sort of a little bit closer to now in terms of when events are sort of happening. And then 3, 4, and 5 are on the same time frame, exactly. There'll be a certain character I'll talk about in one of these where that sort of becomes very relevant. And I believe that the J focused on in Hyena Boy more than likely comes from the third reality in the Circle of Six. So that's why I'm kind of like, no, he's his own little separate one. Because the one that appears in the Tail Saga is obviously from the Sixth, and is set slightly further ahead, and is the first of the Jays in the Circle of Six who A, be born, and B, sort of have his story play out. Although once he reaches the point of death, everything sort of changes, and that's the thing with the Jays in the Circle of Six, is once they've reached their point of death, however they've reached their point of death, their stories then start to diverge a lot more. They all take on very key, very prominent sort of roles within their afterlife, but where they have those roles and what they sort of involve themselves with is unique and different to each one. The sort of primary reason for this is the idea that all the things that they've been through, all of that stuff that they've had to deal with, has sort of prepped them a little bit for the life or for the roles and responsibilities that they are going to take on. Sort of. It's confusing in a lot of ways. There's something about the experience and this particular experience that they've gone through that has allowed them to develop certain personality traits which makes them more suitable for these particular roles. And you know, even though they've all been through fairly similar experiences, it's altered each one in a slightly different way, and the one from the Six probably more so than any of the others, because he had to deal with Oxan sort of being a part of him as well. So he has like the most departure from everything, and actually ends up in the most prominent role because of it. Whereas, you know, the one from the Fourth, which also gets featured, and that's in one of the series that I've yet to start releasing, he also sort of has a very key role within the multiverse side of things, and he gets sort of heavily featured, but the others are there. They are, you know, in the background doing various other things. I've just not focused on their afterlife bit yet. But, you know, he does have a very distinct little personality. As I said, he's an interesting character, in terms of his sense of humour, in terms of the way that he copes with situations. He's very charming. And I think that's what it is. He's very charming, and he rises to the challenge a lot more than I think a lot of people would give him credit for. Definitely in the Tail Saga, definitely in the Sixth, and all the things that sort of play out there. He does sort of get the raw end of the deal a little bit, but for those of you who've read the tales, you might sort of understand a little bit sort of why. So now I want to just touch a little bit on the J that appears in the future reality. Unlike the others, who all have the exact same name, this one's actual first name is William and not J. So unlike the others, his first name is not J, but he goes by J. And he's actually an alien. Well, an alien in terms of being non-terrestrial. Because I don't tend to use the word alien within my series, so he is a non-terrestrial human breed. And he has some similar personality traits to the other Jays, but he's a lot older, he's a lot more mature in terms of his outlook, in terms of the way he sort of does things. He, you know, he doesn't have the coping mechanisms and the defence mechanisms that the others have sort of had to, you know, the ones from the Circle of Six have sort of had to develop themselves. So his personality is sort of developed a normal sort sort of carefreeness rather than the sort of artificial carefreeness that you get from the others. So yeah, he's quirky and he's interesting, and I just love my Jays. I do. There's something about them, and I'm sure when I sort of find other versions of him, whether they're called Jay or not, I will enjoy them just as much, because there is something there. There is something about him as a character, as a personality, and there is a reason that he's one of the characters that I've sort of kicked around for the longest time, and feel like he's one of my companions more than one of my characters. So yeah, not sure what else I can say. Within the set time limit that I've sort of given myself for these now. Right, so the next vlog will be on, again, two characters. And there'll be a reason for it. It's because I know I can say a lot about one and not so much about the other. So yeah, the next one will be on Lecter Arena and Lecter Dana. So life and death. Should be fun. Alright, so I hope you've enjoyed this one, and until next time, see ya.